There's a place, a special place, where wild animals still exist in huge numbers, and nature seems to be the way it was for millions of years. And the name of that place is Serengeti. At nearly 15,000 square kilometers, Serengeti National Park lies in the rain shadow of the Greater Highlands to the east. These highlands rob the area closest to them of water. The land here is dry, especially in the summer. But even here, rock outcrops called koppies hold enough water to support life. These rocky outcrops are really the tops of mountains that have been buried by volcanic activity. They retain enough water during the year to support life, like a gamma lizards, rock hyraxes, and bush hyraxes that are relatives of elephants. And even lions will make their homes on these koppies. It provides an excellent vantage point. Water defines the area. And when there's little water, hippos suffer, and crocodiles have to take refuge in their burrows that they dig in the banks of the river. But for one animal, the wildebeest, the animal which defines the greater Serengeti ecosystem, they need water every day, and the lack of water forces them to move on. And so they begin a migration of about 1,500 kilometers, following the rains as they move north. There are 1.3 million wildebeest in the Serengeti. These animals are constantly on the move. They seek fresh grasses, and as they move into one area, they deprive the animals of the area that they left of their food. Most of these wildebeest will not be killed by predators. Most will die of old age or sickness or disease. Such is the nature of the Serengeti. On the plain stands an acacia tree. Look carefully at it. Look really careful. And as you zoom in with your binoculars, you start to see something, a spotted cat. For this is the realm of the African leopard. Leopards spend a lot of time in trees. It's safe there. They hunt mostly at night. And when they make a kill, they drag it up into the tree. Leopards may be the second largest cat in the area, but they're no match for a lion. In the Serengeti ecosystem, leopards are seldom found far from trees. Elephants, on the other hand, can be found just about anywhere. They'll eat trees, but they'll also eat grass. Elephants are one of those animals that can really change their environment. And they certainly do in the Serengeti, but they weren't always here. 100 years ago, there were very few elephants in the Serengeti. Giraffe can be found throughout the Serengeti. They eat the trees. Zebras are grazers. They eat grasses. But like wildebeest, they must drink at least once a day. There are about 250,000 zebra in the Serengeti Mara ecosystem. Their ancestors first came from North America several million years ago. There are predators throughout the Serengeti. There are about 3,000 to 4,000 lions. They prey on Congoni and Thompson gazelle and are constantly hunting. That is when they're not sleeping, which they do for about 18 hours a day. Nonetheless, you have to be alert for lions. One animal that doesn't worry too much about lions is the Cape buffalo. This animal is large enough to handle them, except large prides. There's an oxpecker on this Cape buffalo, and it's annoying. Oxpeckers eat insects, and they're relatives of the starling. And this, believe it or not, is a starling. This is the lilac-breasted roller. The Serengeti is home to several hundred species of birds. Some of them are familiar, some are not. This is the secretary bird. It specializes in eating snakes. Its long legs give it protection against the snake's bite. And this is the Cory Bustard, the largest flying bird in the world. He's displaying for his mate. The largest bird in the world is the ostrich. And you can find them here too. The ostrich is a ratite, and it has relatives, such as the emu and the cassowary, that are only found in the southern hemisphere. The Serengeti protects a lot of wildlife within its borders, but the rarest of them all is the African black rhino. There are very few of these animals left, and in the Serengeti they can be counted on two hands. The animals are hunted for their horns. The horns are used for the handle of daggers in some Asian countries. We may not have the rhino around for much longer. This is a spotted hyena. It's carrying the leg bone. There's been a kill made. Hyenas are excellent hunters in their own right and are not the scavengers they've been portrayed to be. This lioness had killed a Thompson gazelle, and she's feeding on it. When she's done, she will wander off to join the pride. Vultures will come in and clean up the kill. Vultures are extremely important to keeping the Serengeti a healthy environment, because they take care of all the carrion. Right now, the lion cubs are doing well, but as the great herds move on, many of these cubs will starve to death. Very few make it to adulthood. Being a lion is not easy. Lions are territorial. They must stay in their home ranges, and they cannot afford to follow the great herds. So when the herds move on, some of the lions starve. These lion cubs are unaware of the danger that they face. Play is a wonderful thing, and most young animals play. They learn the skills of hunting, and they also learn who is tougher. Young male lions will be chased out of the pride when they're about 2 or 3 years old. They'll wander around for 4 or 5 years and then try and get their own pride. Lionesses make up the core of the pride. The male will be the master for only 2 or 3 years before another male comes along and defeats him and takes over. In the north lies the Mara River. The Mara River is the major obstacle to the wildebeest migration, but it is also a source of constant water. It's why the wildebeest come up here. And they must cross it, and they will cross it several times. It is a noisy, hectic crossing. They don't like the water. They know danger lurks there. And danger in this case comes in the form of a reptile. The Nile crocodile is the second largest living reptile in the world. Only the saltwater crocodile of Australia is larger. Wildebeest stand little chance against the bite of a crocodile. But life goes on, and most of the 1.3 million animals survive. This young hippo's got an excellent chance of survival. His mother has taken it away from the herd until it gets old enough to join the adults. For now, it's playing too. The Serengeti ecosystem is one of the most studied ecosystems in the world. We've learned a lot from it, and those ideas help structure the way we think about how we can best help nature out. Well, the rains come, and the herds will depart for the south, once again, where they'll have their calves. And the life of the Serengeti goes on. A land of feast and a land of famine, and a land that has much to teach us.